In this chapter, you will learn how to model a quadra car model, a more complex model with two masses and with two acceleration terms. Since you have learnt and familiar with the steps and process to model, simulate and apply control on a simple system, let's get a bit deeper into the modeling concept of quadra car model, which is a bit more complicated than the previous exercise models. Let's work on how to model, simulate and apply the control to this system. A quadra car, as its name suggests, it is to model a quadra portion of a car. In other words, taking one quadra section of a car consisting of single suspension and single wheel and modeling it is the concept of quadra car modeling. The objective of quadra car modeling is to study the behavior of car in vertical direction. Analyzing quadra car significantly reduces modeling and computation time compared to analyzing the full car and provides good accuracy. Here, we can control the damper characteristics based on the comfort level of the chassis. This example is the starting stage of modeling, simulating and control of active damper system. So, let's get into it. Similar to the previous exercises, modeling involves five steps. First one is drawing the free body diagram representation. The components here involve two masses, chassis mass and the tire mass, spring and damper in the suspension, spring effect on the tire, and road input, which is the environment. The vertical positions include ZR, the road position, road height, ZW, the wheel position, and ZC, the chassis vertical position. If we consider quadra car as a single block, ZC dot dot is the output and damping coefficient DS is the input. The constants include the chassis mass MC, wheel mass MW, spring stiffness KS or CS, tire stiffness KT or CT. The damping coefficient, which usually is constant in the open loop model, becomes a variable because it is going to be controlled. Hence, U of T is the damping coefficient DS. The output variable Y of T is the chassis vertical acceleration ZC dot dot, which is measured as the chassis comfort level. Next, let us derive the equations of motion for quadra car model. In a quadra car model, there are two equations involved. Consider MW for the first equation. Displacement of MW is ZW. Downward forces are the weight of the wheel calculated by mass of the wheel into gravity. Force which accelerates the mass is MW into ZW dot dot plus the suspension force, which is force due to spring and the damper. It should be noted that the Fs here should also correspond to the Fs component of mass of the chassis. It should have the same magnitude, but the direction is opposite. Upward force is the tire reaction force from the ground. In equilibrium, the total force is zero. Hence, MW into ZW dot dot plus MW into G plus Fs is equal to Ft. This is our first equation. Considering MC for the second equation, displacement of MC is ZC. Downward forces are weight of chassis, MC into G, and the force mass into ZC dot dot. The upward force is the Fs, spring and damper force combined together. Here you can note that this force is same as Fs from the previous equation but opposite in direction. In equilibrium, a total force is zero. Hence, MC into ZC dot dot plus MC into G is equal to Fs. We can bring Fs to the left hand side and this becomes our second equation of motion. We now have two equations of motion. Let's expand them and have a closer look. Expanding these equations of motion, we get mw into zw dot dot plus spring stiffness into zw minus zc plus damper coefficient into zw dot minus zc dot plus mw into g, the weight, is equal to the tire force, tire stiffness into the difference between the displacements zr minus zw. For the second equation, we have mc into zc dot dot minus the spring stiffness into zw minus zc minus the damper coefficient into zw dot minus zc dot plus mc into g, chassis weight, is equal to zero. We should convert it into the format with which the modeling will be easier. That is, the acceleration should be in the left hand side and all the other terms are brought to the right hand side. By reordering these equations, we get zw dot dot is equal to 1 by mw multiplied by ft minus fs minus mw into g. Reordering the second equations of motion, we get zc dot dot is equal to 1 by mc multiplied by fs minus mc into g. Before I proceed further, I would like to give the key for which color denotes which element. We can represent the same above equations in block diagram format to make the modeling more easier. Let us start with the acceleration terms. They are the multiplication of 1 by mass and an expression. Hence we draw the mass before the acceleration. And that expression is represented by these two sum blocks. For MW we have three terms, FT, weight and fs. Weight can be easily represented as mw into g. Also on the other equation we have chassis weight as an input, mc into g. Now we should compute ft and fs. Fs, as we know already, it is the sum of spring and damper forces, and ft is the tire reaction force. Tire reaction force is equal to zr minus ZW into CT, the tire stiffness. FS is the sum of spring force and damper force. Spring force can be calculated as CS into ZW minus ZC. And damping force can be calculated as ds into zw dot minus zc dot. If we add the spring force and the damper force, we get the suspension force fs, and that can be used in both the equations of motion. Zw dot dot can be integrated once to get zw dot and integrated again to get ZW. Similarly, by integrating ZC dot dot, ZC dot and ZC can be found. These values are fed back again as inputs to the block diagram. They are represented in orange color, ZW, ZW dot and ZC, ZC dot. The road height input ZR is an environment input. This depends on the road data. So this block diagram can be directly used in Simulink. Now you have learned deriving the equations of motion for quadra car model. With these equations, we can model and simulate a quadra car model in Python.